Alright, this is my car. And I have a cow bumper. I can't remember what it's called.
So what kind of car is it? It's a class.
It's an Mod.
Yep. Modified. Wait, let's see if I can get the... There's his body.
That's my old body.
Yeah, he's got a new one, but...
Yeah.
Okay.
And then I'm running these really nice shocks. These are $80.
Got a Traxxas though, too.
Yeah. They're really nice.
You got the little screw right here.
Yeah, see, when you're racing, you don't have to do a quick change. You don't want to grab out those other spaces. Just buy these shocks. Nice, easy twist.
Yep.
And then, yeah. And then I have RPM front. Hey, arms, both sides. Really nice. And I have street tires on this car just because I don't want to have my other tires, my dirt tires. You put them on cement or concrete, whatever. They get ruined pretty quickly. Now I'm running a chair. I can't remember what chassis this is.
I couldn't tell you either. Sorry, guys.
I could probably put it. I'll find it. I'll put it in the description. And I'm running a Boot Boy receiver. And I'm running a Castle
Sidewinder. Castle Sidewinder motor. That's what it's called.
And then this receiver is under this remote. And I want to convert this car over there to this receiver so I can have it on all one remote because it's a pretty nice remote. Screen and everything.
Yep.
And then I'm running, and I have the same tracks in the back, really nice. And then I have...
They're a little longer in the back, too.
Yeah, because it's a push beat. And then I have this bumper in the back. It's pretty strong. It's like a RPM. I really don't know what it is. I think this is aluminum.
Aluminum rear bulkhead? Sorry about that shot, guys. They aren't gonna break.
No, they're. See how thick they are? Probably about half an inch, something like that.
Yeah.
I was telling you about my Toyota Vita. These are steel drive shafts.
Both sides.
Yep, they're really nice because they might bend, but it's probably very hard to bend them. And then let's see, I'm running an 83, 48 pitch, and I'm running a 28, I think.
I
can't see.
It is a 28, I know that.
28, yep.
Sorry guys, but the focus.
When you're running aluminum ones, they're not the best because little tiny rockets in there will destroy the whole thing.
Yeah, that happened to Kenny one race.
Shot a huge rock right there.
It wasn't even that big, and it just, the whole thing was literally flat. I might even still have it. This thing was destroyed.
Flat gear.
So you want to get steel ones. That's a... Oh, I have one of my steering servo. My steering servo is right here. Yep. And I have aluminum. What do you call this thing?
What? This piece?
Yeah.
Arm. Aluminum servo arm.
Yeah, servo arm. And then there's a ton of screws in here to hold the front bar.
Yep.
Yeah, it's a different. So I was reading something about this, and it's actually. There's something under this, and then it's actually a thin layer of carbon fiber on it. And it's $80.
Dang.
Yeah.
So we're gonna show you guys Kenny's next car now. Just let us move over to here.
Okay, and this is my remote for this car.
Just a basic Traxxas.
It's the original one, that's why I want to get a receiver. That goes from
to both cars.
And it's basically
here. Let's give you guys a better shot.
In the other video, pretty much showed you all the car.
Yeah.
So if you want to watch our latest video, go do that.
We'll hopefully put a link in the description. If not, it's just called Kenny's Pit Stuff.
Yep, and then it's basically the same. And
yep, another Castle Sidewinder motor.
Yes, the shocks are different because I broke them. And,
bless me.
Yeah,
I don't know, that's kind of...
It's the same. And
yeah, it's kind of this kind.
SMC, something like that.
Yeah, it's a LiPo battery, hard outside.
It's plastic outside, so...
Mm-hmm. It doesn't bulge as easily.
No, it really doesn't. But this one might be a little puffy. Yeah, it's a little puffy. I'm running SMC. 90C.
Yep, 90C. Okay.
It's a little puffy, as you can see. Focused. A little puffy.
Yeah, okay, I got that.
But it's not too bad for, like, running for, like, half a year. But, see, I've been only running two, because it's my... I labeled it. It's my pretty good batteries, but I'll probably have to switch between batteries because I don't want this thing to blow up on me.
Yeah, sorry about the glare, guys. There's a window right behind us.
Yeah.
So.
And basically this car.
Yeah, that's Kenny's stuff. And we'll go to mine in just a second.
Okay, guys, so I'm seeing it's Trevor here, and here's my setup. So right now, I'm actually running a Slash. I'm turning it into a Midwest Modified, as other people might know it. We call it Short Course Modified. And so let's just start at the front and go back. So as you guys can see here, just regular Traxxas bumper. I'm going to have to get a new one, kind of like Kenny's here, for my new body, but, you know, it's later to come. You know, so as you guys can see, just stock Traxxas shocks. You got some spacers here for
racing. Got the aluminum shock caps.
Yeah, haven't failed me yet. And just turnbuckles, blue RPM.
This one you can see better because he stripped a screw a couple days ago, so.
Yeah, so blue RPM A-arms, blue RPM caster blocks, and it's kind of hard to see, but right back in there is blue RPM steering blocks.
Oh, yep.
Plan is any upgrades that I get, I'm turning it blue because might as well.
He wants to get the LCD chassis too.
Yeah, help with steering too.
Yeah, like mine's blue, so he wants to turn his whole car blue.
Basically. So back here, come close. So Kenny actually gave me this. This is one of those old body clip things. You still love them?
I don't think they have them anymore, but they're really nice.
Yeah, they still do.
I think they have them in your local hobby store, mm-hmm.
But look down here. We actually found a screw. And we put it down there.
Oh, yeah, I see that.
Yep, and we tightened that in there.
Is that a plastic screw?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's okay. And then right here, just a foam spacer block. It's pretty beat up. Kind of want a new one, but, you know, whatever. And then just regular high center of gravity chassis.
Stock.
Yeah, hey, it works, though, you know?
Yeah, he's got a...
So, yeah, I don't know. So I have the Ventiline brushless system.
He just got cut, like, half a year ago or something?
Yeah, 3-4 months ago. And that's pretty much that. This main part of the chassis here, new RPM Nerf bars. Those things are not gonna break anytime soon. Sorry.
And then
here, turn the car around for you guys. So as you guys can see here, just the Ventiline brushless Traxxas motor here.
Really nice in blue.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's the best part. Just rear bumper. I had to replace that recently because that's what I can.
And you got that? Remember you said in the other video?
Yeah.
His new
This is the new motor mount.
Yeah.
And you can't see it under here, but under here I'm running an 8623 gearing.
All right, in that little housing right there.
Yep.
Mine you can see because I took the cap off, but.
Yep, you took it off. I just left mine on. So right here, this is this outside piece of the drive shaft here. This is an upgraded Traxxas drive shaft. They're pretty nice. They're almost like an RPM grade plastic. More aluminum shock caps. And yeah, I didn't take this whole thing apart. It took me like 2 days because I only had like a few minutes every day to work on it. But I take that apart, cleaned it all out, and had to get some new gears.
Yeah, and sorry about the fan if you can hear that.
Yeah, sorry about the fan.
I'm just trying to dry the track.
Yep, for a later racing video. No, bent antenna, but that's pretty much it. And then I just have a regular Traxxas controller like over there.
Like that.
And yeah, I think that's pretty much my setup. Just regular shock oil.
Traxxas.
Yep, see you guys in the outro. As you guys can see, those were our cars. And sorry, we kind of didn't really do much on Kenny's fun car. That's in his pit other stuff video. Yeah.
Yep. And we'll try to get a link in the description, but if you can't,
just
go on our YouTube channel thing.
You'll see it, Kenny's pit stuff. Not that hard to find.
Nope.
And that was this episode of SDRC Racing, and we'll see you in the next one.
Yep.
Bye, guys.